गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स. हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज पुष्टा रियाज, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन ISL इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज इन HNS डिपार्टमेंट. वेलकम टू दिस कोर्स. दिस इज स्लाइटली डिफरेंट कोर्स कॉल्ड बायोलॉजी फॉर इंजीनियर्स. लेट अस हैव द इंट्रोडक्शन सेशन फॉर अवर सब्जेक्ट बायोलॉजी. सिलेबस, व्हेन वी सी द सिलेबस ऑफ बायोलॉजी, this will have 5 units. In unit 1 you'll have introduction to life, characteristics of living organisms, basic classification, cell theory, structure of prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell, and we will be studying about the biomolecules, carbohydrates, lipids, proteins, vitamins and enzymes. In unit 2 we have biodiversity, diverse group of living organisms. We will be studying here about plant systems, animal system and microbial system. Plant system, we'll see about the plant growth, nutrition, photosynthesis and nitrogen fixation. Animal system, we'll see the study of different systems, digestive, respiratory, circulatory, excretory systems and their functions. In the microbial system, we will be studying about the history, types of microbes, economic importance and control of microbes. Then in unit 3 we have genetics and evolution. In this genetics we will be studying about the theories of evolution and evidences, cell division, mitosis and meiosis, evidence of loss of inheritance, variation and speciation, nucleic acids as genetic material, central dogma, Mendel laws, gene and chromosomes. In unit 4 we will be studying about the human diseases, definition, causes, symptoms, diagnosis, treatment and prevention of diabetes, cancer, hypertension, influenza, AIDS and hepatitis, immunity, immunization, antigen antibody, immune response. Unit 4 here we will be studying about the human diseases. Then in unit 5 we'll study about the biology and its industrial applications, transgenic plants and animals, stem cells and tissue engineering, bioreactors, bioforming, recombinant vaccines, cloning, drug discovery, biological neural networks, bioremediation, biofertilizers, biocontrol, biofilters, biosensors, biopolymers, bioenergy, biomaterials, biochips, basic biomedical instrumentation. So this is the syllabus for our subject biology. 5 units you'll have here. And coming to the evaluation part, evaluation marks, 70 marks will be for externals, that will be conducted by the university, and internals will be conducted twice. As you know, average of both the internals will be taken. 20 marks will be the theory and 10 marks will get it from the assignments. And from the biology subject you will get 3 credits. Let us have the first topic of our unit 1, that is eukaryotic cell. Eukaryotic cell, this is the structure of eukaryotic cell. Today we will be studying about the topic, that is the structure of eukaryotic cell. Unit 1, the first topic what we are going to study here is eukaryotic cell. The structure here you can see, inside the eukaryotic cell there are different parts. The parts of this eukaryotic cell, different parts like a Golgi apparatus, mitochondria, nucleus, endoplasmic reticulum. Here you can see two types of endoplasmic reticulum, rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum, lysosomes. All these are the different parts of eukaryotic cell. Eukaryotic cell, we also call it as the true nucleus. True nucleus containing cell, because eu means here true, karyotic means nucleus. So eukaryotic meaning is true nucleus. the cell with the true nucleus. What is cell here? Cell is the structural and functional unit of all living organisms. All living organisms, when we talk about life, living organisms are made up of a basic unit called cell. And group of cells will combine together and form an organ. Different organs will combine together and form the organisms, different organisms. The cell basically is the structural and functional unit of all living organisms. And when we see the characteristics of eukaryotic cells, eukaryotic cells have the nucleus. Main characteristics of the eukaryotic cell is they will have the nucleus, and the nucleus is surrounded by a nuclear membrane. You can see here nucleus is present in the center of the eukaryotic cell, and the nucleus is surrounded by a layer called nuclear membrane. And nuclear membrane, inside that we have a one more structure called nucleolus. Nucleus here is the main controlling center of the cell. It will have the chromosomes, genes, DNA. What is DNA? DNA is the genetic material. Nucleic acids. Full form of DNA is deoxyribose nucleic acid. DNA is the nucleic acid. DNA, genes, chromosomes are the main structures that will help in the passing of the characters from offsprings to parents. Whatever characters we get, that all we will be getting transferred from our parents by this genes, chromosomes, DNA, nucleic acids. All these are the heredity structures that is helping in the transferring of characters from parents to offsprings. So this is the nucleus. Nucleus, you can see here, it is the cell organelle present inside the eukaryotic cell. It is surrounded by a layer called nuclear membrane. And in between you can see small gaps called nuclear pore. And this dot-like structures, what you can see, red dot-like structures on the nucleus. Nuclear envelope. The envelope is the membrane. The layer surrounding the nucleus is nuclear envelope, and on that you can see the ribosomes, the dot-like structures called ribosomes. And continuous to the nucleus we have endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum is the another cell organelle. On that endoplasmic reticulum, ribosomes are attached. Small dot-like structures called ribosomes are attached. These ribosomes' function is they help in the production of proteins. Proteins will be synthesized in humans or in animals by this important cell organelle which is present in the eukaryotic cell, that is the endoplasmic reticulum. The endoplasmic reticulum, on that the dot-like structures, we are calling it as ribosomes. And nucleoplasm. Nucleoplasm here is the jelly-like substance or the fluid content of the nucleus. The fluid content or the jelly-like substance of the nucleus, we are calling it as nucleoplasm. Chromatin. Chromatin is the fine thread-like structures present inside the nucleus. So nucleus is having all these parts: nucleolus inside the nucleus, chromatin, the fine thread-like structures, then one more is nucleoplasm, the jelly-like substance or the fluid content of the nucleus, we are calling it as nucleoplasm, and nuclear pore, these gaps present in the nuclear envelope, we are calling it as nuclear pores, and the nuclear envelope is the layer surrounding the nucleus. And on this nuclear envelope, you can also see the ribosomes, the dot-like structures, what we are calling it as ribosomes. And the production of ribosomes here is synthesis of proteins. So this is an important cell organelle called nucleus, which is present inside the eukaryotic cell. See, all these diagrams you need to copy in your notes, biology notes. Everyone should maintain a separate book for biology, and you need to draw all the diagrams what I am sharing in my lectures. And when you come to college, I will see all these diagrams, and when you practice all these diagrams in your separate book for biology, after seeing all these diagrams, I'll give you marks basing on your diagrams, how you have practiced. So everyone should practice the diagrams. In biology, diagrams are very important. Daily I'll share the diagrams, and you need to draw and maintain a separate book for biology and draw the diagrams. Practice the diagrams well, students. So next we have another cell organelle, that is mitochondria. We have Golgi apparatus, we have centrioles, microtubules, cytoplasms, ribosomes, plasma membrane. The plasma membrane is the cell membrane which is the layer surrounding the eukaryotic cell, and ER is endoplasmic reticulum. We have two types of endoplasmic reticulum here, that is rough and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Rough endoplasmic reticulum will have a dot-like structures called ribosomes, and on the smooth endoplasmic reticulum there are no dot-like structures called ribosomes. No ribosomes you will see on the smooth endoplasmic reticulum, and ribosomes you can see only on the rough endoplasmic reticulum. And cytoplasm here. Cytoplasm is the jelly-like substance or the fluid content of the cell. Nucleoplasm, we have discussed just now, was the fluid content of the nucleus, and cytoplasm is the fluid content of the cell here, eukaryotic cell. This cell will divide by a process, that is mitosis. Mitosis and meiosis, cell division, you might have studied in your 10th class. The main process for the cells to divide and help in the growth and development of living organisms is by the mitosis and meiosis, the cell division processes. Cells will divide by these two process. The outer wall, outermost layer of the eukaryotic cell is the cell wall. Flagella and cilia are the locomotory organs that will help in locomotion. That is, the locomotion is nothing but the movement of the eukaryotic cell will be done by the flagella and cilia, the structures. The cell has mitochondria, the important cell organelles. Mitochondria, what is the function of mitochondria? The main function of mitochondria, cell organelle, is it will help in respiration. What is respiration? Yes, it's not just the inhaling of oxygen and exhaling of carbon dioxide. Respiration is oxidation of food so that it will give us energy. This is done by the important cell organelle present in the eukaryotic cell, that is mitochondria. And this mitochondria, when it performs the respiration process, it will give us energy. And that with that energy in the form of ATP, adenosine triphosphate, ATP will be synthesized by the mitochondria, that will give us energy. And we are able to move our hand, or we are able to walk, we are able to do all the daily activities with the help of this energy. That energy we are getting it by the mitochondria, important cell organelle. Okay, so thank you, students.